It is an interesting and some would say disturbing new trend in these tough economic times. More young women looking to become kept women, or sugar babies, as one new website calls them, helping them to find their sugar daddies who can fund a luxurious lifestyle for these women. The website SeekingArrangement.com claims to already have 300,000 members and says that, in fact, traffic is up some 30% since September. So what is it with this trend? Anna David is a sex and relationship expert and author of Bought. Anna, good to have you with us. And we have you here because you've actually written about these things. We want to clarify, too, for everyone at home. Anna is not a kept woman. She is not part of the website. But you can offer some great insight into this for us. It's funny. I would have thought that it would actually be the reverse, that men these days can't afford to keep women. But actually, women are turning to this because they may not be able to afford the lifestyle they want.
Well, I think that women who have sort of lost their big financial jobs, or anybody who's affected by the economy, there are more women. And there are certain men that are not affected by what's going on in the economy.
Right.
And those are the kind of men, I think, that are in this
And this is an interesting situation because on this particular website, for women, it's free. The men pay $45 a month. For an extra $5, it won't show up on your credit card, which is interesting. A lot of the men are married, and these women come here and some of them get paid by the month. I mean, is this really just legalized prostitution?
Well, the way they skirt the prostitution issue is that, you know, if you're paid for anything else, including companionship, if, you know, you're doing a dish, whatever it is, it's not considered prostitution.
Okay.
And this is actually, your Seeking Arrangement is not a site that's, you know, they say on it, if you're looking for an escort, this is not what it is.
Right.
What they want to do is introduce people to have mutually beneficial relationships,
which they can then decide what those benefits are.
Yes, exactly.
But you mentioned it's not an escort service. So there is a difference between this and, say, a high-class call girl.
Yes, I mean, there is. And what's interesting is the reason I wrote my novel is that I had done this investigative piece for Details magazine about high-class prostitution, where I interviewed all of these girls. Now I've spoken to a lot of the girls from SeekingArrangement.com, and there is a big difference.
What is the difference?
Well, I think it's sort of a need versus a sort of desire situation. You know, the women that I spoke to for the piece were, a lot of them felt very broken. They didn't really have any opportunities. They didn't have any other options. I think, you know, I don't know if it's sort of a class thing. I think a lot of the women on Seeking Arrangement, they're trying to put themselves through school. They're trying to start businesses.
And they're not ashamed about it.
They are not ashamed at all.
They're totally fine with it.
I mean,
and then they move on from here. It is just kind of amazing, though. What about the men? I mean, we say most of the men are married. Is that dangerous for some of these women?
I didn't actually know that most of the men on the site were married.
According to the founder, at a couple of the articles I read, he said, they're saying a lot of the guys are married.
I don't participate in any of it. But I also don't think it's anyone else's job to say what someone else is allowed to do with their sexuality. If married men want to do that and are going to do that, that's what they get to do. If women want to put a price on it, if they think that it's worth this, then that's for them to say. And I think we're sort of a hypocritical society because we see people do this in dating all the time. I lived in LA, trophy wives aplenty. You know, so
that's a whole different segment.
It is.
It does give us lots to talk about, and that certainly gets a conversation going on a Saturday morning.
Yes,
Anna David, great to have you with us.
Thanks.